The assignment problem consists in assigning n resources to n tasks, or n items to n people. As for the transportation problem, we don't have an underlying network structure. Therefore, in order to model it as a transshipment problem, we will need to define an artificial network. Let's take an example. After the death of her husband, my grandmother has discovered 4 masterpieces in her attic. She does not want to keep them. She would like to sell each of them to one of her 4 children. And she has asked each child to make an offer for the masterpieces of interest. And these are the offers that she has received from her 4 children, Harry, Ron, Hermione, and Ginny. And now she wants to sell exactly 1 masterpiece to each child, but she would like to make the maximum revenue from this assignment. What masterpiece should she sell to what child in order to maximize the revenue that she will obtain? In this case, the masterpieces are the resources and the 4 children are the tasks. So we need to assign the resources to the tasks. In order to obtain a network representation, we will define a node for each masterpiece, for each resource, and we will also define a node for each of the children, that is, for each of the tasks. And now we need to include arcs. Well, we will include an arc for each offer that has been made. There was an offer for the Botticelli from Harry, and he proposed 8,000 kilo-euros for the Botticelli. Remember that the transshipment problem is a minimization problem. But here, for our example, the problem is a maximization problem. We want to maximize the revenues. Therefore, we need to change the sign of this value. There was also an offer from Ron, which proposed 9,000, and one from Hermione, who proposed as well 9,000. For the Bruegel, we get an offer from Harry, 11,000, one from Ron, 13,000, and one from Ginny, 14,000. The Kandinsky, there was one offer from Ron, 12,000, one from Hermione, 11,000, and one from Ginny, 12,000. And for the last one, there was only one offer from Hermione, which was not very generous. We have a network now. We have nodes, we have arcs, and we have costs associated with each arc. And the idea now is to send unit of flows through this network. Each of the masterpiece, so each of the resource, will generate 1 unit of flow, and each of the tasks, so each of the children, will receive 1 unit of flow as well. And we will try to do this at minimal cost. Therefore, the data for the transshipment problems are the following. The cost on each arc will be Cij, which would be minus the price which was offered. Again, because the transshipment problem is a minimization problem and the example is a maximization problem, so we have to change the sign. The supply for each of the resource nodes is 1, and the supply for each of the task node is minus 1. This is where the unit of flow will be consumed. The lower bound on each arc will be 0 because we don't want to use the arcs backwards. And the upper bound on each arc is 1 because there will be maximum 1 transaction for each pair resource task. We can now write the optimization problem. So we have to minimize over the vector of flows. Here the size of the vector is n squared, where n is the number of resources and the number of tasks. The sum over all possible resources, the sum over all possible tasks, and we have the cost times the flow. Now we have the constraints, the flow conservation constraints associated with each resource. Well, basically we want that the total flow that goes out of this node is 1. So the sum over all possible tasks of xij must be equal to 1 for I equals 1 to n. So there is one constraint per resource. We do the same for each task. So the sum over all the resource of xij equals 1. And then we need to put the capacity constraints. The xij must be non-negative. Xij must be less or equal to 1. And then we have to impose that xij is equal to 0 if resource I cannot be assigned to task j. In our network, it means that there was no arc for this pair. This is the assignment problem written as a transshipment problem. The assignment problem can be seen as a transportation problem where each supplier is sending one unit of flow and each customer is receiving one unit of flow. As for the transportation problem, there is no real underlying network structure. Therefore, we had to model a conceptual network in order to write it as a transshipment problem. Again, it inherits the properties of the transshipment problem, including the fact that the optimal solution will be integral. And here, integrality means 0 or 1, which are the two possible values that the flow can take.